So, good afternoon, everybody. So, today I will talk of our work that we made in laboratory in Mécoton about Rydberg, called the Rydberg cesium gas. So, in our experiment, the point that we want to make is to create new type of interaction, look at how Rydberg atoms come interact one with another. And here is more or less our latest results. So I will remind you of the properties that were brilliantly already explained by other Rydberg talks on Rydberg atom, their property, how they interact, how what is exactly what I mean speaking of a Forster resonance. Then I will talk about our demonstration of a dipole quadrupole Forster resonance and conclude with prospects and applications. So basically, Rydberg atom is an atom where you excited an electron close to the ionization limit. Then the electron has a very large orbit around a plus one charge nuclear core, more or less just like an hydrogen atom. And as you can see here, the wave function of the atom as a function of the distance is very far away from the ionic core, and the 1 over r potential of the Coulomb force, it's more or less flat here at the position of the atom in the Rydberg state. So this kind of level and procedure are interesting. So first we can cool the atoms sufficiently low so that we can neglect the motion of the atom during the whole experiment, then promote the atom to Rydberg level. They will stay there for a long time enough because the radiative lifetime is proportional to the principal quantum number to the power 3. And and they have a very large radius proportional to the n to the square. So the first effect of this r to the square scaling law is that the polarizability scales like this, and this has two effects. The first one is that you can easily detect the Rydberg atom by ionizing them with field from 100 to 1,000 volts per centimeter, where you can lower the barrier here and have the wave function of the electron escape from the ionic core. And the second one is that we have a strong Stark effect. Maybe I will move my mouse cursor here because it's annoying. The strong Stark effect due to this polar visibility. So now I look at a specific set of level. So remind of your atomic physics course. So it's a D level, so that's the L quantum number, the G quantum number, 5 half or 3 half, and the MG quantum numbers that goes in between. So I note the absolute value here. And the Stark effect is so large that we can have something like 500 megahertz with only 2 volts per centimeter applied, knowing that the interaction strength in this kind of level can go up regularly in the lab to hundreds of megahertz and so on, and experiments don't last more than a few microseconds. So now I go to the Rydberg interaction part. So the electron is orbiting around the ionic core, so basically that's an antenna that will be sending information to this other one, and in the end, what you have is that you have the Coulomb force created by the motion of this electron seen at the position of the second atom. So with this interaction, what you can do, so you can first create some Rydberg atom in some NP level, for instance, and you tune the electric field such that it lies just in the middle between two other states, so the N plus 1s and the ns. In this case, you have coherent oscillations between the two body states where the two atoms are in the P and the other state where one atom is in the P, where one atom is the N plus 1 and N minus 1. And this is often referred as the unresonant interaction and dipole-dipole type. If now the resonance condition is broken, there is not anymore this coherent population transfer, and the interaction referred as van der Waals type. So what we do usually in experiment is that we are able to detect, due to state-selective ionization, the ionization limit for this 3 level is different. We are able to detect in which state the atoms are, so we can scan the electric field around some value and probe this resonance. So as a function of the electric field here, I show the energy of the pair state. So here is the 2p state that we create, and this is the resulting S plus one state. And as a function of the electric field, you can reveal some curve like this. So we measure some probability of transfer to the S state as a function of the electric field. So just here is a brief mention about some talk by Christian Tuesday. He mentioned that we saw some 5-body peaks in the small thing here. Well, probably we see something. We definitely believe that our mechanism for many-body interaction is robust, but to claim that we really see something is a little bit pushing it too far, and we are working a lot on this. Well, so now I come back to the dipole quadrupole Forster resonance, which is the theme of this talk. So the dipole quadrupole resonance, what does it mean? Coulomb potential that I just speak about. And we expand it over the spherical harmonic basis of the two atoms. So you end up with something like this, which is also a development in power of 1 over R. And depending on the spherical harmonic you choose, so the, you can have two index E of G. E or G equals 0 correspond to the charge. So if both are 0, you have the just the usual Coulomb interaction. 1 corresponds to dipole, 2 to quadrupole. So if E equal G equal 1, you have the usual dipole-dipole interaction with the 1 over R cube dependence. And what I will show you today is a dipole quadrupole interaction, 1 over R4. So in order to reveal such quadrupole resonance, we want to stay away from any dipole-dipole resonance because they are typically one order of magnitude stronger in our experiment. We can believe that they would be in the same order of magnitude if the distance between the two atoms would be on the order of the radius of the Rydberg level, and that's typically not the case in our experiment, and that's one order of magnitude smaller, this dipole-quadrupole experiment. So we want to be in a place where there is no other resonance. So for this, the first thing is that you want to change a quantum number, an angular quantum number, by a value of 2. And you cannot do it with the L and the J quantum number because you want to control with the electric field. As soon as you apply some electric field, all the different Rydberg levels will get mixed one with the other. And so you will always acquire some dipole-dipole interaction between two states. So we have to stick with some interaction between Rydberg levels that will change the MJ quantum number by a factor of 2. And in the end, given the experiment constraints, the type of so-called Forster resonance, or more or less the chemical reaction we are looking at in our experiment, is going from the P3 half M1 half state, going to the NS M1 half. So this will be a spectator in any case, and the N-3 half, 5 half, M5 half. So between the first here, M, which is 1 half, and the last one, there is the difference of factor of 2 that ensures that there would be only dipole quadrupole. The dipole dipole is a completely forbidden transition. So, in our experimental setup, so we can produce a dense Rydberg atom cloud just in the middle here that we excite with a short laser pulse. Then we have a phase where we let them evolve under a specific electric field and field ionize them. So with this kind of resonance here, we choose to look at the 25p state here, because it's very convenient. We have two sets of data. Well, maybe I should describe a little bit what I'm showing. So as a function of the electric field, I've shown the pair energy of two states in p, so that would be our starting levels, and one atom in f, the other in s, so that will be for the 7½ f, all those three curves, depending on the m state here, and then the 22f will be the blue curves with also all the mfs here. And so we have two sets of crossings here, depending on the starting state we choose in the experiment, and one of those here is this M1-half to M5-half resonance that is pure dipole quadrupole. So we can test with this resonance that we can see this pattern with three resonances and two, that we didn't miss anything else because the huge number of Rydberg levels that are sitting nearby. And with knowing that, we can see here if we have the same structure of peak with three before and two after. And so this is the test experiment. So we have this three peak and two peaks that really corresponds at the position that we expect them with some amplitude. And now I turn off the second experiment where we are to expect some dipole-quadrupole interaction. And once more, we see those five peaks, and this peak in the middle here is clear evidence of the fact that we have some dipole-quadrupole interaction in our system. So we tried to model our system to understand it better. So we start from the fact that we can compute the interaction between the Rydberg atom knowing their state in the hydrogen-like basis with the quantization axis aligned with the internucleus axis. And we can compute the new eigenstates with the electric field and rotate the multipolar operators, so dipole quadrupole operators with Wigner-Dee matrix to rotate the operators from the internucleus axis to the real quantization axis of our experiment, which is given by the electric field. Then we model the distribution of atoms inside, of Rydberg's atom inside our sample. So we have some random distribution of distance, some random distribution of this angle. We can assume some atomic density that's bound by some other measurement that's not very precisely, taking into account also the fact that plus mg and minus mg states are present in our experiment, and we get some probability transfer for all the resonance that agree very well. So as you can see here, I reported the value, so this corresponds really to 8 if the pointer is going horizontal, this one to 4, and everything is fitting very well. So with this, I come to the conclusion. So we have a very strong evidence of a dipole quadrupole Foster resonance in a cold Rydberg cloud, and this is assured by the fact that between the initial and the final state in the Foster resonance, we have two quanta change in the Rydberg atom state for the MJ quantum number, and an excellent agreement between theory and simulation that shows that we know what we are doing. So this new interaction type is available for anyone who wants to use it. So for instance, you can think of designing strong Rydberg-Rydberg interaction in a situation where no dipole-dipole resonance are accessible. It can be used to engineer weakly bound molecules, also if there is no easy dipole-dipole interaction that you can use. And maybe different spatial pattern from the interaction. So you've got on the angular and on the range of the interaction, we went from 1 over R3 to 1 over R4. This can be interesting for some other experiments. And with this, I thank you for your attention.